Welcome everyone to another Star Wars The Old Republic video, and in this video we are going to talk about the upcoming cartel market items for patch 5.9. So remember guys that with the new system that they're doing, a lot of these items are probably going to be for direct sale on the cartel market, and then they might be releasing a new pack like the ultimate pack, which basically act as packs with really good RNG and give you a decent chance of getting any item from the cartel market. You have a decent chance of getting gold items and platinums and stuff like that, but it doesn't exclusively drop the new items. So these items are probably going to be seen on the cartel market as direct sale items. So with regards to armor sets, we don't have images for a lot of them. There's the armor sets like the Freelance Hunter, the Sly Operator, the Charismatic Mandalorian, the Wasteland Crusader. We do have this image here. I'm not sure what this exactly is an image of, but I do know it's a really nice armor set. I mean, it looks pretty cool. I really like the helmet. The upper body armor has some really nice design. I'm not so much digging the green orbs. I think that kind of ruins it a little bit. It would be a lot nicer if it was just kind of along the same design. But anyways, it's a cool looking armor set. With regards to mounts, we have the Emerald Scale Mantor. This is the only new image we have as with regards to a new mount. The old Mantor wasn't incredibly popular. It still sells for like under a million on the GTN. This one's not particularly nicer, so I'm not digging this one too much. We do actually have the Royal Tauntaun. This seems to be a reward that will be for Twitch Prime members. We have so many Tauntauns in game, so nothing too crazy to get. You can basically go find a very similar looking Tauntaun for quite cheap on the GTN. With regards to weapons, and as you guys can see, we don't have very many items just because with the new system that they're doing, they don't really need to release a lot of new items. A lot of the stuff is just going to be, you know, new direct sale items, I guess you could say. Anyways, with regards to weapons, these are actually quite nice. We have the Imperial E1 Enforcer lightsaber. This is quite a nice looking lightsaber. I've actually enjoyed a lot of their recent designs, like the Resolute Gorilla is still one of my favorites. A few of the other ones have been quite nice. This one seems to be going along similar lines where the design is not too shabby. This one is the dual saber version, also very nice. We have an assault cannon, which I'm not too crazy about assault cannons. I don't know, I don't use commando, so I guess the commandos or the people who still play commando can give me their opinions on what this one looks like. The blaster is quite nice actually. It seems to have this nice orange fiery effect at the bottom. It seems to be a nice compact looking blaster that I think a lot of people are going to enjoy. We have the blaster rifle, which is just an elongated version of the blaster. And then we have the Enforcer sniper rifle here. So all in all, the weapons are decent. We don't have many mounts to show off. The armor sets, I really wish we had images. Unfortunately, we don't have images for them, but the one that they showed was quite nice. Going on into the miscellaneous stuff, we do have a new companion. This one is the A7 surveillance droid. It looks quite nice. We haven't had many of these types of flying droids. I believe the only other one that's similar is the probe droid, and then we have the IO-8 Iocath one. So this one's kind of going along the similar lines. It looks more like a pet than a companion, but it's nice nonetheless, not bad. We have the Darth Hexid companion. Now this one seems to be unlocked not by the cartel market, but by some sort of in-game thing. Like remember a few months ago, we had this sort of challenge where if you completed a certain number of war zones in a certain amount of time, you would get Darth Hexid. And so it seems like they're bringing back Darth Hexid again via an achievement or something like that. So we'll see when that comes out, but it doesn't seem to be a cartel market item. We do actually have a very nice flare though. This one is called Sign of the Captured. It's very nice, intricately designed. I'm really digging this flare. They've done an excellent job with flares in the past. Each time they introduce a new flare, I want to get one for one of my characters. Like the Mandalorian one was great for people who have bounty hunters. The Flare of Prosperity one I really enjoyed. Now this one seems to be another really cool looking designed one. So this one's awesome. Really happy they're releasing that. We have the Advanced Mauve Color Crystal. Not a black color crystal, so I don't care. Anyways, we also have the May the 4th Y7 Astromech Droid. This one is going to be a reward, a pet that's rewarded to players on May the 4th. So I think, I'm not sure if it's just for subscribers. It might just be people who log on, but it also might be subscriber only. So I'm not sure about that. We have the MB6 Micro Defender Droid. This one's awarded for another EA Play to Give promotion. They did one of those, I think, last year, and so this one seems to be another reward for that. And then we do have two new pets. This one's actually quite cool. This one is a juvenile turtle, so an actual turtle. It's got its shell on the back and everything. It's quite cute, looks quite nice. I'm all for introducing new pets, as long as they're not reskins, because with pets, we've seen just an insane absurd number of reskins. So it's cool that we get one that's actually new. Then we have the Isaac's Energy Drone. This one's also new. Kind of cool. Seems to have some cool stuff going up the back there with the whole fire thing. So yeah, all in all, the pets are okay as well. Then we have, well, that's about it, but we do have actually some information in the actual file. So once again, we don't have images for these, but these actually are pretty cool. We have the, well, we have two 7-piece armor sets. We don't know if these are Cartel Market. One is called the Resourceful Renegade, not too fancy, but the second one is actually really cool. This one is called the Order of Zildrog. So this one's related to obviously the Nathma Flashpoint itself. This one just sounds like a really cool armor set. The Herald of Zildrog was a pretty decent looking one. This one is called the Order of Zildrog. And it might be an armor set that is actually released during the Flashpoint, because we did they did announce that the Flashpoint would include one new armor set. So this could be one that actually drops during the Flashpoint. Nonetheless, it's a really cool sounding armor set. We also might get a new weapon. This one seems to be platinum. It sounds really cool. It's called the Gathering Darkness Lightsaber. The Gathering Darkness Lightsaber. It sounds cool. Sounds like it has some really neat effects. Probably going to be platinum rarity. We don't know when it's going to be released though. I highly doubt any of this stuff will be released on patch 5.9. It doesn't seem ready, at least from the data mining on the PTS. And with the new system, there's no real rush to get out Cartel packs, so they're probably going to take some time. Anyways, that concludes the new Cartel Market items. As I said, not much. Before, it was a lot more exciting because, you know, we had a new pack coming out, so it would often include a host of items. But as you guys can see here, a lot of the information is fragmented all over the place. We could get some of this stuff released tomorrow, some of the stuff released next week. We don't really have much information. All in all, not too exciting. The weapons were quite cool, but just everything else is nothing too nothing that gets me too excited. The Gathering Darkness lightsaber, I'd like to see what that looks like. Also, one other thing is the trend we've seen, at least from the last release of direct sale items, is a lot of this stuff will run expensive. So even though it's not the nicest stuff, since it has such a high Cartel Coin price tag, it is going to net you quite a few credits if you want to pick it up off the GTN, which is great for people who have Cartel Coins and want to make credits, but not so great for the people who want to obtain these items and don't quite have the credits or the Cartel Coins to do so. So that's unfortunate. We'll see what happens when these items actually get released. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and let me know what you guys think about these items in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys in the next one.